the Def Expo 2020 in Lucknow, DRDO has put up a large exhibition. It has about more than 40 laboratories participated. More than 500 systems have been displayed, which are developed by DRDO indigenously. This is the largest ever exhibition by a single organization in Def Expo or air show. We have taken up this step as in the last few decades, number of technologies have been developed by DRDO, which are matured and have come to the product stage. And now we want to show it to the world. This is the capability Indian organizations, industries have. Even number of industries which are working with us, who have taken technologies from us, they have also displayed all the products. And today, as Honorable Prime Minister has directed yesterday, our goal is to export in a big number. In fact, he has set a $5 billion is the target in the coming years. We need to work towards that direction. Also, Honorable Prime Minister has mentioned that the large import content which is there in the defense equipment and weapons should be reduced and the indigenous content should go up in a big way. So, we, being the premier defense research and development organization, we need to develop state-of-the-art systems, working on the advanced technologies and make them inducted into the armed forces and also supply it to the world. So, we have had lots of interactions with various industries, various people who have come, and also lots of foreign people who have come also. This time, number of defense ministers of various countries, specifically from Africa, have come, have visited, have shown a lot of interest, have seen our products. The stalls are full with people always, and there's a lot of interest in Indian systems. And I'm sure in the coming years, with the type of discussions what we had with various foreign advanced nations also, we'll be having collaborations in the R&D of the futuristic systems and come out and make sure that in the next 5 to 10 years, India becomes a net exporter. And specifically in the areas of space and cyber, and artificial intelligence and related technologies. As the space and cyber have become the fourth and fifth dimensions of warfare, and as Honorable Prime Minister again mentioned about these technologies yesterday, DRDO also has stepped into these technologies in a big way. Artificial intelligence is taken up by two laboratories simultaneously, and specifically on the job they are working. And I strongly believe in the coming years, every equipment, every weapon will be artificial intelligence based. So we need to work, we need to put a lot of manpower, we need to take a lot of young talent and work on that. And we are geared up for that, and we need to do a lot more, which I am seriously thinking for the roadmap in the artificial intelligence.
Okay, so I want to just ask you, sir, that when you say that a lot of futuristic weapons will be artificial intelligence based, what are the challenges DRDO poses here now?
Firstly, we are now today have dearth of young talent. This is one thing which we need to work on. How to take young talent, how to ensure that the talent of the country joins DRDO, and mechanism of hiring those people is one thing which we are seriously working. And I strongly believe this is one area where young talent only can contribute in a big way. So there are mechanisms which we are working out within the organization, how to have this young talent within the organization to work on it. Same way, young talent is the only one which can work on the cyber technologies. Cyber is very important, as I said, which has become the fifth dimension of warfare. We need to work in a big way. And we have already started, a number of people are already working. DRDO has started very early in this area, and we are working in a big way in these technologies also. Space, as you know, we have demonstrated the anti-satellite capability. And Honorable Prime Minister also mentioned again yesterday, and he also mentioned that we don't weaponize the space, but space we'll use for societal purpose, and we also use it for ensuring that our space is secure. And so this is another area of interest. So there are a lot more technological areas which we are taking up, which we are working up, and we have drawn a roadmap We are working on building large platforms. We are building LCA Mark II. We are going to build AMCA, Advanced Medium Combat Aircraft, and which makes sure that there will be complete indigenous fleet of aircrafts from India itself. That's LCA, then LCA Mark II, then AMCA, similarly Naval LCA, and many of these similar systems. So that is one area. And similarly, we have become very strong in the following areas in the defense today. We are very strong in missiles, we are strong in the radars, we are strong in EW systems, electronic warfare systems, we are strong in AVAC systems, we are strong in torpedoes, we are strong in sonars, and we are strong in the artillery guns also. We have made the 155mm gun the world's longest range gun, which has recently completed development trials, which Honorable Prime Minister also has declared very proudly that India has developed the world's longest range gun. So these areas, we want to have a complete self-reliance, and we like to see that imports are not required in this, making the systems which meet all the requirements of the armed forces. So this is another one. And so now then from there, look into the other areas, other platforms, other technologies where we lack, work on that and try to work with academic institutes, and meanwhile build the industries, try to make them come to the build to specifications level, so that the load on us comes down and many systems can be offloaded to the industry, and whereas we concentrate on large critical and systems which are very, very critical, both technology wise and infrastructure wise, and have an integration and have a synergy with academia and industry and work together and make the country flourish in the technologies and make the country a net exporter, reducing the imports to a bare minimum. As Prime Minister directed us, we have created the Young Scientist Labs, 5 laboratories in 5 technological areas of artificial intelligence, cognitive technologies, quantum technologies, smart materials and asymmetric technologies, and most of them associated with academic institutes, and all the scientists, right from the director to everyone there are below 35 years old, and the director has the same powers as any other director in the DRDO laboratory. And we are also trying to see that there is a flat structure remains in those laboratories, and it is guided by an apex body chaired by an eminent professor or academician or a scientist, which guide them towards various aspects of the technologies what they need to work. So the boys have just started, the boys are very enthusiastic, and they are working on the technologies in their respective areas, and some of them which are working on the current requirements, I am sure in the next 1 year they will be able to come out with products which are really state of the art, which are really world class products, and they will be able to deliver it to the armed forces. Within a year they will be able to deliver. Missiles, one thing is there, last year lots of success were there, air-to-air missile was development trials have been completed, Astra, the QRSAM, quick reaction surface-to-air missile development trials have been completed, the guided Pinaka missile trials have been successfully completed, and NAG missile user trials have been completed, and many other things have been completed, and now this year we are very sure that the Helena missile, helicopter launched anti-tank guided missile trials will be completed, and user trials will be completed. The man portable anti-tank guided missile also this year will have the user trials, and we are very sure of that we will be able to complete that system. And we are taking up other which we are working on already is the NGRM missile, which is air to ground missile, that also will be taking up the development trials in the coming year. And we are working on long range Astra Mark II, which will take us to a longer range air-to-air missile. And these are the some of the missiles which we are working today. And future, of course, some more missiles will go.
And on the weapons front, sir, because there have been some...
Weapons? One is the attacks is one of an important system which we need to go through the user trials and get into the numbers production through the industry, which two industries are working.
Along with Tata, you have developed.
Tata and Bharat Forge,
yes.
And both the industries. And we are also developing a lot of small weapons also,
okay.
Like carbine, which is JVPC, that okay. is already going through the trials.
Okay.
We are sure that it will be able to complete. And we are also developing a rifle, that also we are sure that it will be able to go through. And also, simultaneously, many bombs we are developing. You must have seen that smart anti-airfield weapon bomb has successfully completed its developmental trials. And I'm sure that this year that also will go into production. So lots of weapons are also being developed simultaneously.
There has been always this tag of delays, time and cost overruns.
The days have changed. We are working on that. We are trying to meet our time requirements. We are trying to be very aggressive in the time frames. And so, QRSAM, we have completed the developmental trials now today. And we have completed in a very short span of time the guided Pinaka missiles thing. And we have completed the SAR trials. These are all done in any world standard in a fast way. And we are also now very aggressively working on the schedules of LCM Mark II and AMCA. Okay. And I'm sure that both the LCM Mark II and AMCA will be a world record okay. in developing these systems. So that's how the teams are geared up, the teams are motivated very positively. There's a lot of positive energy in DRDO today, and the youngsters are motivated. And the Honorable Prime Minister particularly has given lots of motivation. When he came to dedicate the Excellence Laboratories, he has put in so much of confidence and faith in DRDO, which actually is motivating the young scientists in a big way today to work for the organization and the country.
All right. So finally, what is that you, since you said there is a dearth of youngsters, this is my final question in DRDO. So what is that you want to tell the youngsters, you know, who will be listening to this interview?
Firstly, you don't have to look only for a government job, and there are enough opportunities. Youngsters are coming up with lots of startups in many areas, including the defense technologies. They're doing wonders. The people whom I know who keep meeting me, they're doing wonders. So work with DRDO and work with any industry, or have your own startup, produce wonders, develop wonderful systems, and supply to our armed forces, supply to the world, and make that India is not only excellent in ICT area, they're very good, and they're world-class people, or world's best people in all the other areas also.